A government decision today could affect thousands of women suffering from advanced breast cancer. A Food and Drug Administration panel said there's no proof the drug Avastin is safe or effective for those patients and should not be approved for their treatment. KXAN's Jared Wise has the story of an Austin woman convinced it's prolonged her life.
Darth Vader.
By the looks on these faces, it's hard to imagine anything could be bothering them. But for this wife and mother, the last 6 years has been a struggle.
It doesn't make sense. I was 33 years old when I was initially diagnosed.
Diagnosed with breast cancer in 2005, for years she was on the verge of beating the disease. But just a few years ago, she found out her cancer had spread her entire body. At the highest level, stage four, she had few options.
If anything stands a chance of prolonging my life here as a mother and a daughter and a friend and a wife, it's worth trying.
Her doctor recommended a cancer-fighting drug, an Avastin, a drug which helps prevent the cancer from spreading by restricting blood flow to cancer cells.
We were overwhelmed by the response because it wasn't spreading, it was slowing down.
Many women also say the drug helped them as well, many showing up at a two-day hearing in front of FDA panel members and pleading for the drug's approval.
Lack of evidence is lack of evidence. There's no survival advantage with Avastin.
The panel voted against approval because they felt the side effects, the most extreme of which they cite as death, outweighed the benefits.
I don't think it's fair. I think that should be left up for the patient choice. If someone is willing to take that risk to save their life, and it's been approved before, it's kind of, to me, it's kind of like denying a person the opportunity to live in some cases.
Betsy's cancer remains incurable, but for her, she says the drug has improved the quality of her life, and she wants others to have the same chance.
It just saddens me so that this won't be an option for so many women.
Spoke with Betsy's oncologist this afternoon. He says Betsy, along with others who have used the drug under his care, have responded well. And just because the FDA may not approve Avastin's use for breast cancer, that doesn't mean it still can't be prescribed. The problem is that without the FDA's backing, it may not be covered under insurance. In that case, it could cost patients about $90,000 a year. Reporting live in the studio, Jared Wise, KXAN News.